Hello everyone, welcome to Appa Public School Kalburgi. This is Jyoti, your IT teacher. Let us start with your Unit 5 Digital Presentation. Unit 5 Digital Presentation, in that Chapter 15 Introduction to Presentation Software. Now let us understand, what do you mean by a presentation software? A presentation software is an application software which is used to create multimedia presentations in the form of slideshows. Then, what do you mean by a presentation? A presentation is a collection of slides arranged in a sequential manner to convey the information. Then, what do you mean by a slide? A slide is an electronic page or a digital page of a presentation. Then, what do you mean by a slideshow? A slideshow, it contains the slides in an organized manner in order to convey the information to the audience. So these are the general terms in the presentation. Now let us see some of the presentation software. So we have LibreOffice Impress, Adobe Connect, Google Slides, Microsoft PowerPoint and OpenOffice Impress. So these are few examples of the presentation software. Now let us see the components of a presentation. Now these are certain components of a presentation. First one is regular text, second one is background and title, and third one is graphic elements like clip art, graphs, charts, then date and time, transition and animation, header and footer, and slide number. Now let us see this one with the help of an example. Basic elements of a slide. In that, first one is background. Background is the base of a slide wherein you can add the charts, graphs and any other elements, and the background can be modified. Then the second one is the title. Title is the heading which is used to tell the audience about the content. Then the next one is the body text. It contains the main content of the topic. Then we have is the date. So date can is displayed at the bottom of the slide, so it can be removed also. Then the next one is the footer. So footer is present at the bottom of the slide, so here you can write your institution name or else any of the theme of the slide. Then the next one is the slide number, which indicates the current number of the slide. So even the slide number can also be removed. So these are the various elements of a slide. Then characteristics of a good presentation. So first one is well designed. The presentation should be well designed. It should be to the point, and the point should be related to the topic which you are going to present. So all the topics and the contents and the figures should relate with the main topic. Then the second one is use of colors. So you can use different colors to make the presentation look more attractive. Then third one is you can also use high quality graphics and 3D elements. And the next one is animation and videos. You can also insert animation, transition and videos to make your presentation look much more attractive. Then the next one is correct use of grammar and language. So for a presentation, it is very much important that it should be error free, and the language which we use should be understandable by both the listener as well as the speaker. Then the next one is keep it simple. So you can keep the presentation simple by using the figures and the charts so that the listener and as well as the speaker can able to understand what they are telling. Then next one is keep it simple. So you can keep the presentation simple by adding the figures and following the logical hierarchy. Then the next one is minimize facts and figures. Then it is always important that to make an eye contact with the audience. So these are the certain characteristics of a good presentation. Practicals. By the end of the chapter, you understood about the various elements of a presentation and what are the characteristics of an effective presentation. In the earlier chapter, we have discussed about what do you mean by a presentation, what do you mean by a presentation software, and the basic elements of a slide, and what are the important characteristics of an effective presentation. Now let us begin with the chapter 16, creating a presentation. Starting PowerPoint. So in the Windows 7, the steps are start, all programs, Microsoft Office, and Microsoft PowerPoint 2010. Then in Windows 10, let us click on the Start, then scroll through the list of folders and select Microsoft Office, and then select Microsoft PowerPoint 2010. Now let us see this one how to do. To start PowerPoint application, firstly go for the Start button, and then you can directly select Microsoft Office PowerPoint 2007 or 2010, or else you can search in the search bar here. So these are the methods of opening a PowerPoint application, the PowerPoint window. So let us see the components of the PowerPoint window. The first one is the Office button. So as you can see here, this is the Office button. So in Microsoft PowerPoint 2010, Office button is replaced by the File tab. The Office button, it consists of certain options such as New, Open, Save, Save As, Print, Prepare, Send, Publish and Close. So these are the certain options provided by the Office button. Then the second one is the Quick Access toolbar. So this is the Quick Access toolbar, which is present at the uppermost left corner on the top. So it consists of the frequently used commands. Then the third one is the title bar. So this is the title bar on the top. As you can see here, it contains the name of the current presentation and then the name of the application. So the name of the current presentation is Digital Presentation and the name of the application is Microsoft PowerPoint. Fourth one is the ribbon. So the ribbon consists of the 8 tabs, that is Home, Insert, Design, Animations, Slideshow, Review, View and Developer. So as you can see in the figure also, this entire box, the horizontal box, is the ribbon here. Then the next one is the slide pane. So the slide pane is the area, blank area, where you can write your text. Then the next one is the status bar. So status bar is present at the bottom, as you can see here, right? It contains the number of the slide or the slide number, and then the theme name, and then it also consists of the views and the zoom slider. Then the next one is the slides tab. So the slides tab shows the thumbnail version of the slides. So here you can delete, move or duplicate the slide. So as you can see here, this is the slides tab here. Then the next one is the outline tab. So the outline tab contains the text contents of each of the slide. So you can edit the contents here. The next one is the notes pane, as you can see here in the figure and even in the application also. So here, where it is there, it has, click to add notes. So you can write the notes regarding the current slide. Then we have is the view buttons, as you can see in the figure, view buttons and the zoom control. So these are view buttons. We have 3 views: normal, slide slotter and slideshow, and this is your zoom control here. Then we have the control buttons like minimize and then close, maximize, right? So these are the different components of a PowerPoint window. Creating a blank presentation. Now let us see the steps to create a blank presentation. Firstly, go to the Office button or else the File tab if you are using Microsoft Office PowerPoint 2010. Then click on the Office button, then click on New. So new presentation dialog box will be displayed. Select the option Blank and Recent from the template section, then select Blank Presentation, then click on Create. So as you can see, a new presentation window is being displayed and the name is given as the presentation 1, and the file name extension of the presentation will be .pptx. So this is the blank presentation. Now let us see how to create a presentation using the built-in templates. So for that, go for the Office button, click on New. So a new presentation dialog box will be displayed. In the template section, select sample templates or install templates. So install templates. So as you can see, already some of the built-in templates are available here. So click on any one and then click on Create. So you can use these templates to create a presentation. Selecting slide layout and adding text. So let us see how to select a slide layout and adding the text. So slide layout is the basic structure of a slide. Now here, to select a slide layout, so let us take a new presentation here. So I'll go for here and create a new one, right? Now here we have an option called as layout in the slides group. So select the layout option here. We have different layouts: title slide, title and content, section header, two content, comparison, title only, blank, content with caption, and picture with caption. So these are already the basic structure. So you can select whichever layout you want. For example, if you want title and content, select it. So as you can see, the slide is changed to the title and content slide. Adding text. So now let us see how to add text in the slide. So firstly, here we have click to add title. For example, I'll give the title as communication, and then I'll write here also like verbal, non-verbal, visual, right? So these are the different types of communication, right? So you can also change the design of the slides. So go for the design tab here. We have certain themes here. So select whichever theme you want. So I've selected this theme, or else anything, whichever you want. So any theme you can select here. You can change the colors here, right? So as you can see here, the color is changed. And then you can also change the font styles, and then you can also apply the effects here, right? You can also change the background styles. So to apply different background styles to a slide, go for the background styles option in the background group. So click on the background styles, click on format background, then select whichever option you want. So I'll take it as picture or texture fill. So I'll take the texture here, I'll take it as this one, right? So if you want, you can apply to all, right? And then click on close. As you can see, the texture is done. So or else you can change once again, go for the background styles, format background, gradient fill, click on apply, then close. So it is changed to the gradient fill. So this is how you'll apply the background styles to the presentation. Now let us see how to save a presentation. So I've created a presentation here. So if you want to save a presentation, go for the office button, click on save, right? So the save dialog box will appear. So select the location where you want to save. So I've selected as documents. So give the file name. So I'll give it as 34, right? And I click on save. As you can see, the title of the presentation has been changed here to 34, right? So this is your file name. So this is how you'll save a presentation, or else you can take the save option from the quick access toolbar here. So there, or else you have a shortcut key, Control plus S. To save a presentation using password, go for the office button or file tab, then click on save as, right? Then select the location where you want to save. I'll select this PC, I'll select the desktop, right? Then go for the tools, then general options. So as you can see here, general options box has been displayed here, right? Here you can write the password to open. I'll give the password as 123, right? And then click on OK. And then you can re-enter the password, that is 123, then click on OK. Then you can change the file name here. So I'll make it as 45, and then click on save. So this is how you'll save the presentation using a password. Running a slideshow. So to run a slideshow, either you can go for the slideshow button here, then click on from beginning, so it will start the presentation from the beginning, or else from the current slide. So as of now, I'll take it as from the current slide. So as you can see, the current slide is being displayed in the slideshow view, right? Then the next one is, you can use the FY key, or else you can click the slideshow button on the status bar. To run a slideshow, you can select the slideshow view in the status bar. So this is your status bar at the bottom. So you can select the slideshow view, and to quit the slideshow, you can press the S key on the keyboard, right? So this is the different steps to run a slideshow. Then next one is, how will you open an existing presentation? So to open an existing presentation, either you can press the Control plus OK combination, or else you can click on the file tab or office button. So click on the office button, select open, then choose the location where you have saved, right? So I have saved it on a desktop. So there is one folder called as unit 5. So I'll select the presentation here, right? So then click on open. So as you can see, the new presentation has been opened here. Next month is using help. So if you require any help in the PowerPoint presentation, then you can directly press F1 key or else you can click on the question mark button here. So this is Microsoft Office PowerPoint help. So when you'll press, you'll get a PowerPoint help option here, right? Then the next month is closing the presentation. So in order to close a presentation, go for the office button, then click on close. So it will ask you whether do you want to save the changes, then click on yes, no, and then cancel, and click on yes. As you can see, the presentation has been closed. Then the next one was how to close the application. So to close the PowerPoint application, go for the office button, then click on exit PowerPoint. As you can see, the PowerPoint has been closed here. So these are the steps, practicals. So now we will be able to create a new presentation, save a presentation, run a slideshow, and then close a presentation and using the help option. So these are the topics which we discussed in the chapter. Chapter 17, working with slides. In that, inserting duplicate slide. So if you want to duplicate a slide, firstly select the slide which you want to duplicate. So I have selected slide 3, then right click, then click on duplicate slide. So as you can see, slide number 3 is duplicated here, right? Then again, if you want to duplicate, there is one more method. Select the slide which you want to duplicate, then go for the home tab. In the slides group, in the new slide option, select duplicate selected slides. So this will duplicate the slide. The second method to duplicate a slide is select the slide which you want to duplicate, then in the home tab, in the slides group, in the new slide option, select duplicate selected slides. So this will duplicate the slide. As you can see here, slide number 4 and 5 are both same. So this is slide number 4 and this is slide number 5. So the slide has been duplicated here, right? Then next month is how to insert new slides. So to insert a new slide, firstly select the slide where you want to insert, then right click, click on new slide. As you can see, a new slide is being inserted here, right? So below the slide number 5, or else in the home tab, in the slides group, you have new slide option here. So you can click above, or else you can also select different layouts here, right? So this is the method to insert a new slides. Modifying slide layout. To modify a slide, go for the view tab, then select the slide sorter view. As you can see, the slide sorter view gives you the thumbnail view of the slides. Now select the slide which you want to modify. For example, I have selected the slide number 1, right? Now by selecting the slide number 1, then go for the home tab. In the home tab, in the layout tab, select whichever layout you want. So I have selected the title and content. So as you can see, it has been changed now, right? The slide number 1 has been changed. So you can view in the normal also, right? So the layout of the slide has been changed here, right? So this is the way to modify the slide layout. So next one is, how will you copy a slide, move a slide, and delete a slide? Now to copy slides, there are 3 methods. First one is, either you can select a particular slide, right click, and then click on copy, and then select where you want to paste. For example, if you want to paste here, right click and then paste. Or else you can go in the home tab. In the home tab, select the option copy here, right? And then you can paste wherever it is required, right? Or else you can press the Ctrl plus C key combination to copy a slide, and Ctrl plus V combination to paste a slide. This moving the slides. So to move a particular slide, select the slide which you want to move. For example, if you want to move the slide 8, so I'll just select the slide, then drag it to the position where you want to move it, right? As you can see, the slide has been moved to a different location here. So earlier it was slide number 8, it has become slide number 6 now. So this is the way to move the slide. Then the next one is deleting the slide. So if you want to delete the slide, either you can select a slide, then press the delete key on the keyboard, or else you can select the slide, then right click, then delete slide. So this is the method to delete a slide. Now let us see how to copy and move and delete a text in a slide. So let us take an example here. So I have one more presentation here, right? So if you want to copy the text, just select the entire text, right click, then click on copy. Or else you can go in the home tab and select the option copy, or else the shortcut key Ctrl plus C key combination. So I have copied the text here. Then if you want to paste, I'll select a new slide, right? Here I click on paste. So as you can see, the selected text has been pasted here. Or else you can press the shortcut key Ctrl plus V key combination. If you want to delete a text, firstly select the text, then right click, then click on cut. Or else you can use the shortcut key combination Ctrl plus X. Or else you can select the cut option from the home tab, right? Then to move a text, right, firstly select the text, right, and then you can drag and place it in a different location, or else you can copy and paste. Controlling the size of the view. So in order to control the size of the view, either you can select the zoom slider which is present on the status bar. So here is the status bar in the bottom, right? You can select the zoom slider here, right? As you can see, it has been changed now. Or else in the view you have an option called as zoom here, right? So you can select whichever zoom percentage you want. So I'll select 66%, right? Then I'll click on OK. As you can see, the zoom has been made here, right? So this is how you'll control the size of the view. Then workspace views. So to change the view of a particular slide, either you can click on the view tab, and then you have the options called as normal, slide slotter, notes page and slideshow in the presentation views. Or else you can select the view on the status bar. So on the status bar you have here, right, at the bottom here. So you can select the view from here. So in that, the first one is normal view. So normal view is the view what you are seeing now, right? So all the slides are displayed at the beside and the main window also. So this is the normal view. In the normal view you can add the text, graphics, animation, transitions as well. Then the second one is the slide sorter view. So to shift to the slide sorter view, go for the view tab, then select slide sorter. As you can see, the slide sorter view, all the slides have been displayed in the small size. So it is the miniature display, right? So here you can select the slide and you can delete it, copy it, and you can change the layout of the slide. Then the next view is the notes page view. So I click on the notes page here. As you can see, here you can write the notes regarding the slide, right? Whatever notes you want, so which will help you in remembering. So this is the notes page view. Then the next one is the slideshow view. So to go for the slideshow view, go for the view tab, then select the slideshow, right? As you can see, this is the slideshow view. So to quit the slideshow, press the ESC key, right? So these are practicals. So now you will be able to change the slide layout, to copy and move the slides, to copy, move and delete the contents of the slide, and then learn about the different views of a presentation. Thank you.